We're going to cover the four key elements behind strength training for baseball, and we're going to start right now. What's up, everybody? It's Dane Miller from GarageStrength.com, and if this is your first time to the channel and you're interested in becoming a freak athlete, you want to be more explosive, you want to react a little bit quicker, you want to be a better baseball player, make sure that you like, you subscribe, and you ring that notification bell so we can help you become a beast. One of the biggest misconceptions in the sport of baseball is that athletes that are baseball players don't really need to strength train. And oftentimes baseball players and baseball coaches will propagate these lies and these misconceptions that you don't want to get big and bulky. You don't want to be these huge hulking bodybuilders. Strength training is not actually going to help you in the world of baseball. And you want to stay away from the weights because it's going to hinder your throwing mechanics. And these are all misconceptions from the 70s, the 80s, even the early 90s that we're still stuck with today, that generation after generation is just passing on for no reason. And we're here today at the University of Oregon's PK Park at their baseball stadium. And one of the key factors behind a lot of Oregon's success is their strength training regimen. And so what can we focus on? What are those key elements behind baseball strength training? That first key element is going to be joint integrity, okay? If we can focus on joint integrity as a baseball player, we can focus on specific co-contractions in our shoulder. We can focus on strengthening our elbow. We can focus on improving our hip mobility. If we can improve our hip mobility, we can have a little bit better lateral movement. Again, if we can improve our shoulder mobility or our shoulder integrity, we're gonna be able to throw a little bit harder. We're gonna be a little bit more stable inside that entire shoulder girdle, and that's gonna lead to longer throws. That's gonna lead to more powerful throws. And even to a point, if we're working on joint integrity, even throughout our wrist, now we can get more revolutions on the ball when we're throwing it. Now we can get a little bit quicker flip of the wrist when we're batting. So these are all really, really key components behind improving your performance as a baseball player. So one of those key concepts is focus on joint integrity when you're doing resistance-based training. Focus on movements and exercises that you can utilize to enhance your shoulder strength, to enhance your elbow joint, to enhance your hip mobility and power output. So if we can do specific exercises for mobility and specific exercises for strength training in these different joints, now we can improve our overall performance on the diamond. That second key concept that we've got to focus on is agility. We've got to be agile when we are playing baseball. There's a lot of stop and go activity. There's also a lot of work around being on the baseline. We're sitting there waiting and waiting and waiting, and then all of a sudden we've got to move very, very rapidly in a side-to-side movement. So if we can be really agile, we're gonna be able to cover a little bit more ground out in the field. We're gonna be able to react out of the batter's box a little bit faster. And all of those components will help you become a better baseball player. So when we're focusing on training, what can we do from a strength training perspective to help with agility? We can do movements that are actually going to increase our strength from a lateral perspective. We can do movements that are gonna increase our strength from a specific static start. So these are components that we've got to recognize that can improve the realm of baseball performance. When we're training agility, strength has a massive impact on agility. The stronger we are in a certain area, the stronger our legs are, the more we can cut a little bit quicker. If we can think about a batter, they're standing in the batter's box and they make contact. Now, the strength that they have from their hips is also going to transfer to the power and the agility that they have to get out of that batter's box rapidly. And so it's important to understand that strength has a huge impact on being agile. And that actually leads us into that third key element, which is going to be focusing on reactiveness. Typically, I don't believe that reactiveness is going to be a key component behind most sports. I think that oftentimes you can lump reactiveness in with another element, which we're going to provide later on, but that key component here of being reactive is very necessary for the success on the baseball field. If we can think about a center fielder, they've got to be patient, right? They've got to be sitting there and they have to be aware of what's going on in the game. They've got to understand the game situation, where they need to be from a defensive perspective. And then when the ball comes off the bat, they have to react quickly. And it's the same thing if we're playing shortstop, first base, wherever. there's a lot of reactiveness. There's a lot of very rapid reactiveness that goes into baseball. Even think about a catcher. The catcher catches the ball, they see the player on first base take off to steal second base. They've got to react extremely fast to get the ball down to second base to make the play. So when we are in the weight room, we can use auditory signals to train reactiveness. We can clap our hands when we're trying to get an athlete like Bryce Harper to do a power clean. We can use visual signals to trigger reactiveness. And that's another important aspect, is that when we're playing the outfield, we are going to see things happen faster than we hear things, okay? So we have to train both of those key aspects when we're talking about reactiveness. You have to train it from an auditory perspective, and you have to train it from a visual perspective. Now, that's going to improve your reactiveness as a batter, but it's also going to improve your reactiveness as a outfielder. Think about a batter now with reactiveness. If they can see something come off the hand, if they can see quick enough how the pitcher is actually releasing the ball or the angle at which they're releasing the ball, they can guess a little bit more effectively as to what pitch is coming at them. And if their reactiveness is trained from an auditory and a visual perspective, that's going to drastically improve their odds of making contact. So train reactiveness in the weight room through various protocols. Use auditory commands where you tell the athlete to actually do a power clean or a box jump at a specific moment. Use visual gauges like different color templates to create a reactive protocol when we're doing specific plyometric movements, and that's gonna transfer really well to an outfielder or a shortstop or anything along these lines. But now that final key element behind success in baseball is being explosive, okay? You have to be extremely explosive. When you learn how to use your hips, when you learn how to utilize your posterior chain, now you can hit the ball farther. You can run faster. You can react quicker if you're out in the outfield, or if you're playing shortstop, if you're playing third base, if you're a batter, if you're a runner, if you're on first base and you need to steal second base, or let's say that there's quick contact and there's two outs. If you can take off a little bit faster because of the explosive work that you've been doing, now that's gonna transfer to a little bit higher percentage of you being capable of scoring. So if you have the speed of somebody like Ricky Henderson, or you have the explosiveness of someone like Bryce Harper, who does do Olympic lifts, who does do full cleans, now that's gonna make you a little bit more explosive. So that's really, really an important concept here, is that we don't wanna shy away from the Olympic lifts. We want to engage with them, because that's gonna help us with our bat speed. It's gonna help us get out of the batter's box a little bit quicker. It's gonna help us as a fielder. It's gonna help us even if we're pitching, if we're doing the Olympic lifts, if we're doing power cleans, if we're doing light power snatches, if we're doing full cleans. We're gonna be more explosive when we're throwing the ball. And if it goes back to our other elements, if we're playing first base and we are more explosive and we're training that third element of being reactive and we're focusing on joint integrity and we're really honing in on those specific actions to help us be better on the field. Now, if I'm playing first base and a lefty smashes a fast grounder at me, I can react quickly, I'm more explosive, I can see with those visual commands that we've trained in the weight room how that's gonna carry over to a faster reactiveness as a fielder, and then I can actually make that play a little bit more effectively. So we've gotta focus on all four of those key elements to improve our play out in the diamond. Don't shy away from the Olympic lifts. Try to focus on utilizing them to train that explosiveness. Make sure when we're training reactiveness that we're using different auditory and visual commands. Make sure we're trying to improve our general strength so that we can be more agile. And then finally, in baseball, we really, really, really have to focus on our joint integrity in our shoulder, in our wrist, and even in our hips to try to optimize our overall performance. So if you want help with strength training for baseball, click on the link down below, head over to garagestrength.com, and you can pick up our strength training for baseball 12-week strength training program. If you want more content around baseball-based training, click on this card right here. Until next time, guys, peace.